Hey, what's up, guys and girls? Anatoly is here, and this is my entrepreneur mindset vlog. As you know, recently I have decided to record day by day some videos to share with you about the mindset, motivation, and especially some tips and which you can implement to improve your business. And especially every Wednesday, as we decide with my team, it's gonna be every Wednesday. Once in a week, I'm gonna be sharing with you tactics and strategies and basic general information about the e-commerce, entrepreneurship, and Facebook ads, Shopify stores, and anything related to the business. So if you would be interested for some exact topic, just DM me or write that in the comment in YouTube, and I will be recording that for you, and you will be learning from my experience. So today's topic is gonna be about the schedule, how you should to schedule your days when you are an entrepreneur or you're just trying to succeed in some field. Because without the scheduling properly your days and make the task for yourself, you're gonna be not able to achieve kind of results which is are in your mind, and especially how you have to set your goals, because you have to set the goals for the short term, for the long term, and after that scheduling your time how to achieve them. So let's go. Just want to tell you, if you are trying to be an entrepreneur or you are already an entrepreneur and something doesn't work for you, or it works perfectly well and you want to scale that but you don't know how, so then you have just to organize your schedule for 7 days a week. As an entrepreneur, you must work 7 days a week. There is no excuses about that. Only 7 days a week lifetime, working lifetime, will help you to succeed. Yes, we are running away from 9 to 5 to be a free, to be an entrepreneur, yes? But at the end, when you're an entrepreneur, you're working much harder and much, I would say sometimes much more, many more hours just to accomplish the results which you are planning to. And it sounds something illogical, but believe me, it is the freedom. You can schedule, you can make the schedule for yourself as you want. You can work at night, at the evening, during the day. You can miss one day, but I don't suggest you that. Whatever it happens in my life, 7 days a week, I'm next to my laptop. I'm doing the stuff which is support my company, Golden Stream Media Agency, which is I'm a founder of, and how to, you know, succeed the company and what kind of issues or what kind of improvements we can implement there. So that's why 7 days a week, it must. You should not make any excuses. You are sick, okay, you could work a bit less hours, but at the end, you're gonna be doing at least something to get one extra step to the goal which you were planning for the week. So that's why, like what I'm doing, I will share with you now, and you can exactly modulate that in your own way. And believe me, like I would really happy to see some kind of comments in the bottom, just that you were implemented, and after a couple of weeks or months, it was helping you improve your results at least 2 weeks at least, because usually when you start organizing everything, it's like 10x easily if you never done that before. So small steps. First thing, what I'm doing in the morning. I woke up or at 6:30 a.m. At 7 a.m. I'm already in the gym. It helps me to be feeling much healthier, my body feeling much better, and I'm just doing exercises to keep myself, I would say, keep my body full of energy during the day. It's really helpful when your body is strong and it feels really much more energetic, and it's motivated to make more stuff during the day. And why 7 a.m.? Because people always crying, and even me in the past, that there is no time. There is no time for the health, for the exercises. So I decided to remove all the excuses, and for last 6 months, I'm just waking up earlier and going in the gym and doing the exercises. So it is the 7 a.m. till 8 a.m. 8:30, I'm just taking a shower at home, having breakfast, and moving to my office. Because before I used to work at home, and it's actually cool, it's awesome, I mean, nothing special, it's fine, because I can do my work from anywhere. But when I rent the office for myself, I realized that it's really something. it is the place where I can focus only on the business, and there is not going to be procrastination to play with the son because I have a kid, and there is a lot of things which could be attract me to not working. So that's why office space, it's something really the best what you can do if you are a family person. If you are alone, still I would suggest you to work somewhere in other places, but you can do that from home. So take a shower, went to the office, driving there, take a cup of coffee and start working on the business. First thing what I'm doing, I'm just writing the goals for the day. So I make 5 to 7 tasks what I should do during this day. And after that, I'm just moving step by step by each task to implement whatever I need to achieve that kind of small micro goals, as I call them, to make my day much more productive and improve my company and improve in general what I'm doing. Okay, so this is about the during the day what I'm doing in the office time. And I have as well different days of the week where I'm focusing on. So Tuesdays and Fridays, it's media buying call where I'm having a meeting with my media buyers managers. We are looking for the ad accounts. We are checking what we can improve, what can be done better for our clients. We are discussing any kind of situations which they are having with the clients. And then we are just finding the solution, brainstorming ideas, and after that they are implementing with the clients for the best customer service and especially for the best results when it's related to the ads. So this is for Tuesdays and Fridays. On the Mondays I have our media buying call about the improvements of the strategies. So it's not about the clients Tuesdays and Fridays, it's about the clients and accounts, customer service problems or what to improve. But Monday media buying team, we are having a call about improvement. What's going on? We have a Telegram channel, yes, so what we can do better. We have some kind of ideas, so how we can implement, who could be taking care of that. So Monday, it's more like general preparing the week for new ideas and new achievements, okay? So Tuesday, Friday, then it's media buying calls for the customer ad accounts. Wednesday, it is the management call with sales department, with media buying department all together. And we are sharing what kind of results has been done during the last 7 days, what kind of ideas we can implement for the sales team to get more clients, what kind of webinar we can prepare, or what kind of information we can provide to improve it. Like for example, we have got published, like my name has been published on the Yahoo Finance. It was awesome. Before we never implemented, but now it's really, it's huge trust. Why I should not share that? It's awesome. Like plus 7 figures awards. This is something what as well I have got from one of my mentor, my main mentor. And this is what helps me be more productive, and at the same time, like this is what exactly is happening when we are brainstorming what we can improve. So here is 7 figures awards by myself, my own results, and now we have already 6 of seven figures. So it means over 6 million in this clients' sales through Shopify stores by using Facebook ads. Our agency have made for our clients over $6 million in a bit more than 1 year. So that's why Wednesday we are discuss with the sales department what we can improve to provide more value for our potential clients, how we can pre-qualify the clients, because we don't want to take on the board everyone. No way. We are start pre-qualifying clients right now by the exactly different categories, which is in our opinion important to be a part of our team. So it means we are pre-qualifying them to be a good fit to work with us or no. If we are seeing that this person is not understanding how business is running, is not understanding that it's required investments in the advertising, it requires time for sure, because believe me, like any kind of business would never build in a few days. It's always takes time. And people who are staying with us for a while, they always getting results, always. So that's why those kind of people who are understanding that and they have a budget for the advertising, we are accepting them to work in our team and be a part of our e-commerce family. So on the Wednesday, we discuss all this stuff. We brainstorm, you know, the ideas from the sales department and media department, how to improve it. And after that, we just delegate the duties, like who's supposed to do what to improve any kind of part of the business. So it's about the Wednesday. Thursday is mostly my time where I'm trying to learn something. So it actually during all the days, I have a couple hours to learn something, to watch important, important content, which is really helpful for me, or networking with people who are doing bigger number than me. I have a network of the friends who are doing really similar numbers or higher numbers than me. I'm speaking about 8 and 9 figures people that if I need, I'm paying for the call to speak to this really successful people and find out what is working for them. If you are not doing that, you are like, seriously, you're going to nowhere, because believe me, networking with the right people who have the same mindset as you and similar goals as you, or maybe especially if they already achieved that goals which you have, it will help you push forward, moving forward without any excuses, because you will see that those people can do why you can't. Like before, for me, was a dream, 3,000 extra in a month to make for my family, 3,000 extra dollars income. But now I'm looking behind and I'm achieving much, much bigger results. And for me, now it's funny what kind of small thoughts I had when I just start my entrepreneurship. But it's fine. Like, we are having micro goals. 3,000, it was the beginning. After that, 10,000, it's 30,000. It was 100K for the year. After that, it was 500,000 for the year. Now we have like $1 million in results for our client in a single day, our goals, because it will bring our agency to 6 to 10 million a month if we're gonna be doing $1 million in the results for our clients. So obviously, if clients are getting results, we are getting paid and clients staying with us longer. So that's why we build a goal in the client's results, because it will be opposite part for us make the profit. And it is really goal which is we are going to. Our biggest month right now in May, it was $750,000 in one single month in the client's results. But our goal, as I already said, 1 million a day in total client's results. So we make that kind of goal. It could sound really a bit crazy or big, but I know that it's achievable, because I'm speaking to the people, I'm not working with people who already done even bigger results. And I realize like why we can't achieve that kind of results. So that's why I know that it's completely achievable. We just need to be sure that we are working on the building a perfect structure to delivering more results to the clients, to multiply and expand our company with the good employers, to be able to deliver the best customer service to those people who are staying with us and who are on the way of testing products or on the way of scaling. So how we can improve that, like with the fulfillment support, with the customer service support, and so on. So Thursday, I'm learning most of the time about something new, some extra tips. And especially if we find out on Monday or Wednesday that there is something new supposed to be implemented, on Thursday most of the time I'm full searching for this information. Or one of our managers, if we decide that one of the managers, let's say Bogdan, he will be taking care of that, he's searching and we just discuss that, like what he has found out, and from my side I'm trying to find out something else. So this is about the Thursday. Friday, as I said already, it's a media buying for the clients. And Saturday, Sundays, it's all about, from my side, I'm focusing on the numbers, analyzing the numbers of the last week, of the last month, seeing the difference, if it was growth or it was the drop down, what could be the reason, if we got some kind of ad accounts blocked or business managers we lost. It could be done. It's like it's part of the e-commerce business. So I'm seeing what kind of situation we have by end of the week. And plus, I'm learning something new. I'm reading the books about the entrepreneurship or some general business books, which is really must be in your schedule. In one of the next videos, I will share with you what kind of books really changed my mindset and changed my life, which allows me to open my eyes and understand that, okay, everything is achievable. Everyone had different difficult situations in life. And I was thinking that I'm alone, but actually every kind of entrepreneur had similar background. So that's why, like, I just have to do the same what they have done. What they have done, they didn't quit. They were just moving forward through all the failures, stand up, and again, went to the next steps, to the next level of their success. So this is about the schedule. Please, first thing, the most important you have to do is write the goals, daily basis. Write the goal for one day, write the goal for the week, and write the goals for the months and for the year, obviously. Because now you have a goal for the year, you divide it by months is what you have to do to achieve that goal at the end of the year. And you're gonna be split that monthly goals to the weekly goals, and after that daily goals, micro goals, which just allows you to make the small steps to the goal of the year. I would tell you something that because of all this scheduling, what I'm done for last more than 2 years, because I'm in e-commerce 3.5 years, and the last 2 years I was really organized with the scheduling and the goals, which I'm writing all the time. And the most thing what was helpful for me, it's writing everything on the paper. Last year I made for me a goal, which was only 50k in the agency, and we have done over 100k, and it was like just beginning for us. And I was really super, like, I was super excited because I couldn't believe that it could happen. For this year, goal was much higher. It was 10x goal. We didn't achieve that goal, but what is important, goal was so big that we achieved 5 times more if it would be placed the goal of 2-5x. We achieved really the goals, which is in last year, would be unreal for me. And because I placed a huge goal for this year, which is looks unreal, I was able to achieve much more if I would be making my goals lower. You understand what I'm saying? So that's why, like, now we have a goal, $1 million in a day. And if we won't even achieve $1 million in a day for somehow, but I'm sure we are able. I know that by these goals in our mind, we're going to be able to achieve at least $700,000-$800,000 in a single day with the client's results. You see what I'm saying? Then bigger goal, then more chances that you're going to be achieve much bigger results. If you would be placing the $500,000 a day, we would achieve maybe 300, 400, maybe 500, because our mindset will not be in this kind of small break. But we made 1 million a day, and we won't stop until we're going to be improving enough to really get what we need, what we want. So that's why schedule your weeks and make the results, improve your schedule, improve your daily routines. Never forget about the health. Believe me, without health, it will be difficult to manage. I know that because there is a lot of stressful situations. I don't want to make that video super long. It's already like, oh, I believe over 18 minutes. Just keep organized and be sure that your schedule for the week is completely done to focus on your business. 7 days a week. Don't procrastinate. Otherwise, you won't be on the level where you want to be. Okay? So speak soon and have a wonderful week.